Hello everyone, welcome to Sabre Virtual Demo. Our brief videos explain different features of Business Central and related products. And in this video, we're going to look at timesheets. I'm going to explore how you can enter time, submit time, and then have it approved or rejected by a manager. So here we have Business Central, and we can see here that on our role center, we can see a self-service area where we can see any timesheets which are currently still open. We can see any timesheets that we may have submitted already. We could see any time that may have been rejected by our manager, and we can see also approved time. So I've gone ahead now and I've drilled into my open timesheets. So I've gone ahead and created Patrick as a resource that uses timesheets. So I'm going to drill into the timesheets. And as you can see, I've already entered a little bit of time. The status is still open, meaning I have not submitted them yet, so I can put in a timesheet towards jobs, services, I can report an absence. The assembly time gets posted through the assembly order process, but I can see that approved timesheet there as well. So when you want to add a new line, you're going to just go ahead, you'd be able to select, you know, the different area, you'd be able to go ahead and select the different job that you want to post the time to. And I'm going to go ahead and post a little bit of time on the Thursday. So I can see over here in our timesheets, I've got a little bit of an overview as to where time is, how things are totaling up, how my week is totaling up. So once the user has entered in their timesheets, they can go ahead and submit the lines that they want their manager to approve. So using the control key, I'm just going to select a few of my lines here. Let's say I'm going to submit all the time that I used working on jobs. So under process, I'm going to go ahead and submit. So I can see here I could submit all of the lines that have a status of open or just the selected line. So I will submit just the selected lines. And we can see here our status has now been updated. So now coming back to our role center, I can see here I still have some timesheets that are open. I can see here that I've got some timesheets that have been submitted. I don't have any still that have been rejected. And of course, because I have that one assembly order line marked as approved, I still have my approved timesheet. So now it would be time for the manager to go in and either approve or reject those timesheets. So again, I've created a user. They're marked as being a timesheet administrator so that they can go in and of course perform that function. So I'm going to go into here, manage timesheets. I can see here lines that have been submitted, and of course you can filter this list and create a little saved view for yourself to optimize, but I'm going to drill in to that specific timesheet. I'm going to review the lines that have been submitted. If I wanted to, I can always go in and add comments to the timesheet or to the line if I want to communicate, you know, why I approved or rejected time. Maybe I want to send some comments back to the user. But of course, if all looks well, under the process button, I can approve. And again, it could be all submitted lines, so it's going to be the four lines that we saw. Or if I wanted to, I could just select certain lines and approve those. And I may be doing that in the case that I want to take other lines and then reject them. So I've gone ahead and done that, and now the status on the line is marked as approved. And these lines are now eligible to be pulled into a job journal, suggested from the timesheet, and then post it so that this time and this cost can actually go into the job. So I'm going to go ahead now and navigate to my job journal. Under the prepare, I'm going to suggest lines from timesheet. If I wanted to, I could interact with some of the filtering, but I'm going to go ahead and just suggest everything that I have. We can see here these timesheet lines, the respective job, the resource, the time, and the cost associated. And once everything looks good, I can come up here and post to then again communicate these to the job, have them associate to the job ledger, and have all of these times and costs moving forward. Thank you for watching our videos. Please follow our channel by clicking here or click here for more great videos. We look forward to seeing you next time.